So, a couple of months ago, I coded this Flappy Bird clone that lets you control the bird using hand gestures, or virtually any two distinguishable pixel arrangements from your smartphone camera. I did this using the Kane and machine learning algorithm with the ML5 library for JavaScript, and I was curious whether I could also apply this to other kinds of things. So I coded a little snake game and tried to use KNN to make it play on its own. However, this did not work that well. I had issues getting the right file format of the canvas, so I could pass it through the ML5 library, and even after I managed to do it, the difference between the different snake and apple positions were probably too small, since a giant portion of the screen was white, no matter where the snake or the apple were located. I didn't want to just stop there and give up, so after a while I came back with a different approach. I coded a small canvas you could draw on, and my goal was to let the computer decide what shape the user drew. Instead of actually using a neural network to do it with KNN, I just did some math with the pixels of my canvas so that similar drawings would yield similar results regarding the brightness of each pixel. That way, I could just compare the drawn image after applying some math to it with the training images to detect the drawn shape. This actually worked surprisingly well. However, I would have had to input the training image for every possible size and position of the shapes I wanted to detect. Doing that wouldn't only be really tedious, but it would also slow the process down a lot, since a new drawing would have to be compared with way more training samples before a decision could be made. So I took another break, brainstorming ideas how else I could achieve something like that, but without the need of having to spend countless hours drawing the same shapes over and over again, to just end up with a program that takes multiple seconds to detect a new shape. And I came up with something. Instead of only using the final drawing for the detection, I checked while the user is drawing if a big change in the drawing direction happened. In other words, whenever a corner is drawn on the screen, I marked that spot, so I could use the corners later to detect triangles and rectangles. But because humans are rarely able to draw perfectly straight lines, I let the mouse snap to the currently drawn line. Only by violently moving the mouse, a change in direction could be achieved. But this felt odd, so I started over again. This time I added a bigger threshold, so you wouldn't need to draw as straight lines as before, and it worked quite well. I also added a small circle holding a brush and a color palette, which was going to be the main character of this game. Yes, game. My goal wasn't just to detect shapes for no reason. I wanted to make a game out of this mechanic. So additionally to detecting triangles and rectangles, a simple line would throw the circle in a given direction. All this worked really well, but it was still a little strange, since the drawn lines were perfectly straight, and corners really close to one another would only be removed after letting go of the mouse button. So I trashed my code yet again. After a small break, I started coding again, and this is what I came up with. What you actually see on screen is exactly what you're drawing, and all the corner detection and straight line math stuff happens behind the scenes. I also improved and tweaked it over and over again. For example, to get a rectangle, now all angles have to be about 90 degrees as well. Additionally to triangles and rectangles, I also added a detection for a simple lightning ball shape, which was slightly more complicated, but not as much as the other shape I added. I don't really know why I added this, but for some unknown reason I decided I also wanted my code to be able to detect circles. So that's what I did. To make this an actual game, I added a score counter at the top of the screen and two enemy types, triangles and rectangles. The triangles appear at the sides or at the top of the screen and fly towards the circle. Drawing a triangle causes the nearest triangle to disappear into the abyss, and it increases the score counter by one. Rectangles appear on one of the sides of the screen and move from one side to the other, jumping occasionally. Same as with the triangles, drawing a rectangle makes them disappear and increases the score counter by one. Touching a triangle or rectangle makes the screen go black for a brief moment and resets everything. So that's where I'm currently at. Feel free to leave any suggestions for the lightning bolt and circle shape in the comments, or anything else you would like to see added to the game. Once I added a few more things to the game, I will be posting a better version on my Discord, so feel free to hop on there. The link is in the description. I will also occasionally post updates on my Discord about what I'm currently working on, which is not only what you're seeing on my videos.